Hello and welcome. We're going to take a look at how to extract music or sound data from a game in the Unreal Engine, Unreal Engine 4. As an example, we have Super Inefficient Golf. Here are the properties in Steam, so we can find the files. In local files, browse local files, we only have 770 megabytes, which is very convenient because huge games make this job a lot more annoying, trying to find the files. You might have to extract gigabytes of data. And here, let's take a look. There's Sticky Snowball, which is the name of the project. We got content and packs, and here this most likely contains all the files. This is 550 megabytes, it's probably the lion's share. It is the lion's share of the whole project. In binaries, we only have, apparently, the .exe. This contains maybe the icon, but probably nothing else. In engine, we will find binaries, third party. All right, this is just libraries, and they are packed deep in these folders. Okay, so DirectX is here. Wait, well, DirectX is not here, but whatever this is, Pix Event Runtime. NVIDIA, what do we have here? GFSDK. And config contrain. I don't know what that is. Probably some config file format. Extras, redistributable, just Unreal Engine 4 prerequisites installation, 40 megabytes. Don't need that. Already installed. Plugins, runtime, NVIDIA, again, Ansel. Oh, I see. So this is what it looks like. Ansel gets its own DLL file. Very, very interesting indeed. And then common redist, also just setup files for things you might need. This is actually 100 megabytes. Jeez. A whole different level of inefficiency. Okay, so we're going into the project folder and in content and packs, and this is the first thing we want to unpack. So first we need to unpack this. If we try to use 7-zip, this just doesn't work. We get an error. We're gonna start with Quick BMS, generic files extractor. Let's download it. Here it is. And let's find UE4. Nope. Unreal Tournament. Maybe this will match. Unreal Tournament 4. Let's give that a try. Here are the files. I just moved them here for convenience. Let's unpack Quick BMS. Extract all. Extract. Let's just go into that folder. I'm just gonna cut this and paste it in here just to make it easier on us. Remember, this is the file. And now let's just run quickbms.exe, not 4 gigabytes, because this PAK file is less than 4 gigs, so we can just run this. And yes. And this opens up and it is in the same folder, so it's very useful to copy or move quickbms to that folder. So read the title of this window. Select BMS script type. We're going to use Unreal Tournament 4. And now it says in the title, select input archive files. And for that, we're going to use this, .pak. And now we're going to select a folder. And for this, we're going to just create a new one. Extract, enter, and save. And it looks like there is some success going on. 5,000. Nearly 6,000 files. We can press enter and it's gone. Let's go to extract. Let's take a look at Sticky Snowball. Okay, we actually get an Unreal Engine project. We could actually edit this in Unreal Editor maybe. That would be weird. So let's check content and maybe music. Nope. Sounds. Let's check sounds. And assets. And music. And gameplay music. Alright, so now we have UAsset files. Alright, so now we have the UE viewer that might help. Let's download this one. Windows version. I just placed it in here. So let's extract this one as well. And let's go in there and just run umodel.exe. And yes. And what we get are these two windows. Path to game files is not exactly correct. Let's just select the gameplay music folder. And what I want is audio, so let's get the sound. And OK. Now we get this window, two UAsset files. This one is only 2 kilobytes, so I'm going to pick the big one, 7,000 kilobytes, 7 megabytes. And we're just going to press export. What we get now is an exporting packages progress bar and a notification. Unreal Engine 4 version U model has found an unversioned UE4 package. In order to work correctly, please specify which Unreal Engine 4 version is used for this game. I don't know. I do not know. So it finished, and this is a UE4 opus file. Can we just drag this into VLC and be gone with it? Is it just perhaps an opus file? Nope. Okay, so VGM stream might help. Guess we're gonna go here to build passing, where we can probably download the latest, as they call it, artifacts. I think the test zip is it. There we go. Here we have it. Let's extract it as well. Okay, and here we find this stuff. I just copied the UE4 opus file in here as well. Let's run a command line. Let's shift right click and open command window here. Sometimes PowerShell will open instead. In that case, just run cmd in your PowerShell and you will be on the same state. Let's see, test.exe dash h doesn't exist. Here we go. So let's just say out.wav, and now the name of the file we want to extract is zig and tab, and it works automatically, and I think we're done. There is the out file. Man, this has been some work. Let's get the out file in here, and let's listen if it actually works. It does. Oh my goodness. Finally we are done. Congratulations. Now you know how to extract audio from some Unreal Engine 4 games. Remember this step, I think this was the point where you might have to select a different version. Try different Unreal Engine versions if that doesn't work. Anyways, I hope this tutorial helped. Give this video a like. Let me know in the comments what other stuff you're trying to export for modding or fan art and such. Subscribe to the channel to support it, and I will see you in the next modding video. Ciao!